Hello everyone. Today we are going to learn with the third experiment of ED and I laboratory. I have told in the last session there are total 12 experiments. In that, 8 experiments are hardware based and 4 experiments are software based. The 4 experiments in the software based, we are using the LTSpice software. In that 4 experiment, we are going to simulate today, and the first experiment is input-output characteristic of BJT in common emitter configuration. Before simulating the experiment, we have to learn theoretical background of BJT input-output characteristic and CE configuration. First, let us know what is BJT. BJT is nothing but, all of you know that it is a bipolar junction transistor. It has 3 layers, 2 junctions, and it has 3 terminals. One is emitter, base and collector. Usually transistor which is having 2 types. One is NPN transistor, one is PNP transistor. The transistor widely used in rectifiers, amplifiers, switches, filters, etc. There are 3 type of configurations: common base, common collector and common emitter configuration. In the 3 types, common emitter configuration widely used. Why the common emitter configuration which is used? Because it has low input impedance and high output impedance. Also, it has high voltage and current gains. Definitely, if it is high voltage and current gain, the power gain will be high. And the application of CE configuration is most of the thing we are using in the amplifiers. In the amplifiers, we will be getting 180 degree phase shift. So therefore, in the switches also, we are using. Let us know, in the common emitter configuration, here we are using in the NPN transistor. In the NPN transistor, so N is termed as a collector here, P is termed as a base, and N is termed as a emitter here. The base and emitter is in the forward bias, collector and emitter will be in the reverse bias. In the forward bias, the P which is termed as a base, so P will be remain as positive itself, and emitter is termed as a negative, it will be in the negative terminal. So the biasing voltage will be here VBB. In the reverse bias, it should be N should be become positive, and the other term will be, other end of the terminal will be negative, and VCC is our biasing here. VBB and VCC are the 2 biasing supply, and IC, IB and IE, the direction of the current flows shown in the figure. The schematic diagram of the common emitter configuration as shown here. In the forward bias, we are having the ammeter, so that is the base current. The emitter which is applying both input and the output side, which is common. So commonly which has applied between the input and output, therefore we are calling as common emitter configuration. Here we are in the input side, in the forward bias, we are taking as a IB is a input current. For this ammeter, the supply which has connected here positive, the positive supply which is this terminal is also positive, the other end is negative. At the same type, at the reverse bias, this end is positive, this terminal will be positive and this end will be negative. And this is the input current, the input voltage is between the base and the emitter. So the input voltage will be the VBE, and the terminal will be, this end is negative and definitely the other end is positive. At the output side, the voltage, output voltage, we are calling as VCE. This end is negative and the other term is positive. This is the way of writing the terminals. Now, applying to the forward bias as an input characteristic. When you are raising the VBB, So you have to note down the input characteristic. What do you mean by input characteristic? Input characteristic is nothing but it is the curve between input current with respect to input voltage and maintains the output voltage constant. X-axis is always represents the voltage. So the input voltage with respect to this circuit is VBE, and the input current with respect to it is IB, and we are maintaining output voltage constant. How the input characteristic will be appear? So when the VBE starts increases, it will be in the zero. After the voltage drop across the diode, means if it is silicon diodes, it will be 0.7 volts, the voltage drop will be 0.7 volts. If it is germanium diode, it will be, the voltage drop will be 0.3 volts. So if 0.7 volts, you are having voltage drop, after that there is a sudden rises in current. This is your IB, it starts increasing after 0.7 volts. If you increases the VBE also, the IB starts increases. The VCE is you are making constant as 20 volts. Now you have to manage the output voltage constant in different levels. The next other output voltage if we are taking, so VCE is equal to 10 volts, you will be having the rising current of IB like this. Suppose if you reduce the VCE is equal to 1 volt, you will be getting the 0.7 will be the barrier and you will be getting the waveform input characteristic like this. You will be getting the different way of input characteristic. Now let us know what is output characteristic. Output characteristics is nothing but it is the curve between the output current with respect to output voltage and input current remains constant. Output characteristics y-axis represents the output current. Output current here is IC and output voltage is VCE, and maintaining input current remains constant. So now you are varying the output voltage, then starts increasing the collector current. After some time, so the collector current remains constant and VCE starts increases. So at the different levels of IB, so you will be getting the output characteristic like this. So if it is IB is equal to 0.2 milliamps, always the IB in the milliamps, you will be having the, if you are varying the IB, suppose 0.4 or 0.6, the waveforms will be, the IC is also increases. If you are varying IB is equal to 0.6 amps, milliamps, the IC is also, you will be getting the different level of output characteristic. If your IB is zero, then definitely, so you will be getting the waveform like this. The collector current will be small. If it is 0 milliamp, so definitely the collector current will be stop, will be less. In this way, the input and output characteristic we have to observe. Let us work in the simulation model now.
Hello everyone, welcome back to the simulation session. Just now we have completed the theoretical background of BJT. The input-output characteristic of BJT in CE configuration, we came to know that theoretically. Now we have to do with the practical experiment. So with the simulation, how to do? First you have to go with the Google Chrome, write down LTSpice simulation, download you go. Then click on LTSpice Design Center Analog Devices. Then go back to the download for Windows 7, 8 and 10 version. Here you click and download it, you will be getting the LTSpice software in your system and install it. After your installation, you will be getting here LTSpice, otherwise you go here, you will be getting a symbol like this, LTSpice, double click it, it will be get opened. Now go to the new schematic, you will be getting the new window. Now for BJT characteristic, what you have to do, theoretically we learned that one transistor should be there, two resistors should be there, and two biasing voltages should be there. Now first we'll draw a NPN transistor, write down NPN transistor from this gate window, then keep it in the center, click it, one more it will be coming, but you press escape, it will go off. Now right click on it, you will be getting the pick new transistor, double click it, here you have to select BC547B, BC547B, press OK. So the transistor is BC547B you have taken. Now for base and collector, one resistor it is required, press resistor here. So it is in the vertical mode, you cannot connect as it is, keep it in the horizontal mode. For that what you have to do, Control R, it will be coming in the horizontal mode, click there wherever you want, and for the R3 you press escape, it will go off. Now you want two voltage sources, again go to the component, write voltage, press OK, you get two voltages here. Then for third one, you press escape. Now you want one ground, ground is here, keep it here, one more ground we don't want, press escape. Now your connection has to be done, wire, you get one horizontal and vertical line, click from where to where you want it to get connected. After the voltages to ground, has to connect to ground, and from emitter to ground it has to go. And at the same time negative terminal you have to connect it to ground, and the positive terminal it has to go to the resistor, from the resistor end to the base. Again escape, you will get the cross mark, cross icon. After your connection you have to set the values. Now for R1 you suppose right click it, and for resistance how much, 10k you keep it. After the tolerance you make 0.001%, press OK. And here this R you keep the value as RC, this is the resistance, capacitor resistance, you keep it as RC, and this is the base resistance, keep it as RB, press OK. Now the value should be here, so RC the value should be here 1K, 1000 means 1K, press OK. And again I have not kept the tolerance here, so it's okay, no problem. So now this V, instead of V, it is not required, you can remove this, press OK. And here you keep it as this is VBB, is okay, and this one V is not required, and here keep it as VCC. Press OK. Now go to the simulate. Now the circuit we have connected, but you have to set the voltage level. Voltage level we have not yet set right now, but only the resistance, transistor and voltages we have taken and we have connected. Now you have to set the voltage level for VBB and VCC. For that you have to go to the simulate, edit simulation command. Here you have to select DC sweep. In the first source, it is the VBB. In our case, type of sweep is linear, start value is 0 and stop value is 2. Increment in steps of 0.2 you can keep, and after for the second source you will be having VCC. Your second source is VCC and start value is 0, stop value is 20 volts, and increment in steps of 2 you can keep. Always the base voltage, means VBB biasing voltage, it should be within the range of 2, means the current will be in the microamps or milliamps. In the VCC you will be getting in the milliamps. For that reason you will be having the biasing potential 0 to 20 for observing the output characteristic. Now we press OK. This you keep it somewhere inside the schematic diagram. Now you can observe, so the VBB volts you have kept for 0.22 and 0.2 in steps it will vary, and here 0 to 2 and it will vary in steps of 2 volts. Now the connection is over. Now you have to run the diagram. You will get a window like this, characteristic window. I have told that input characteristic you will be getting. So where you have to put for the input characteristic, you have to observe here. Means the current IB and the voltage VCE here. For the VCE is you will be getting in this point, and IB you will be getting here. If the black arrow mark is not coming, until that you have to search. Once the black arrow mark you will be getting, click on that, you will be getting the different levels of output voltage constant. Now you are having 0.6 volts voltage drop. I told that in the theoretically also silicon is a 0.6 volts breakdown voltage and germanium is 0.3. Here we have used the silicon type transistor, therefore 0.6 after 0.6 voltage drop, so there is a sudden rising current. So this is the base current you are getting. So this is the input characteristic with respect to base current with emitter base voltage. The x-axis which represents emitter base voltage and the y-axis represent the base current. Now once it is over, you have to input characteristic now over. Now you have to study the output characteristic. For that again run command, and after the run command you have to search where the icon should be there, means where you have to find out the voltage and current. For that in this point you have to search, because the collector current here you will be getting, at the same time collector emitter voltage also you will be getting. Now you click on this, you will be getting the different values of IB output characteristic you will be getting. Here we have kept IB is a constant, and the x-axis represents the collector emitter voltage and y-axis represents the collector current. Now you see the base current increases, the output characteristics also it will varies. So this is the observation of the output characteristics. In this way you also try in your system and verify the input and output characteristic. I hope you have understood. We'll come back to the one more session, LTSpice with different experiment. Thank you.